Hello everyone, this is Matthew with Quiet Mind Yoga. I am hopping on our live video feed already so that way we can get prepared for our 7 p.m. class, the yoga flow. Alrighty, get yourself comfortable, whatever that looks like for you. Get a blanket if you have one, or block, or bolster, whatever you need for the class. We're not necessarily gonna utilize those items, but if you want them, then you grab them. Maybe you light some candles. Ah, that's what we forgot. Candles. I said we were gonna light candles tonight. So I'm gonna go ahead and light some candles. You get a diffuser, candle, incense, whatever you need, and we'll start in about 3 to 4 minutes. Alrighty. No, I don't see that one. Hello, y'all. We are setting up for lighting some candles, getting ourselves ready. You do the same, get in your comfortable area of your house, wherever you can be comfortable, and get yourself ready. I want another candle. Oh, we have this one.
Let's go ahead and use it.
Right here?
Can you see it or
not? Can you see it? Yeah, you can see it actually.
See? Mm-hmm.
That's okay. We'll stick with that one. Can I see the bottom? I'm going to change this. Also, is it unlocked? Hello, hello. Hey, Estella. Welcome, y'all. We are setting up. I'm lighting my Palo Santo, as always. As I mentioned earlier, get whatever you might need for class, whether that's a blanket, it's a block, it's a pillow, if you need a strap, or you don't have a strap and you want to use a belt, grab a belt as well. Just set up the scenery so that you can get comfortable and relaxed, because that's what we're aiming for tonight. Start in 1 minute, y'all. 1 minute, get yourself situated. Get comfortable. Hello, hello. Hey, Rebecca. Also, y'all may want a blanket just to sit on. I grabbed some from our house. I don't necessarily have the technical yoga blankets, but I grabbed just some regular ones that we have just so we can sit down on them and be a little bit more comfortable while we are seated. We are gonna go ahead and jump in. So if you're not already, go ahead and make your way onto your mat or your carpet or your floor, whatever you are on right now to practice, and we'll settle in. Seated position, whatever that looks like for you tonight. Maybe it is your legs crossed, maybe it's your legs straight out in front of you, maybe it's on a chair, you can sit on a blanket or a block to elevate you. Elevating the hips does help to release some of the tension on your hip flexors and your lower back, so it can feel a little bit more comfortable for you. All right, sit up nice and tall. Place your hands on your knees, palms to face down. This will help us to ground tonight. I've had a lot of people say to me today that they are feeling anxious. So anytime that you are feeling anxious, one of the things that I recommend you go to is to ground yourself. Whatever that looks like for you right now, it's gonna be palms to face down. Sitting up nice and tall, close your eyes if that feels okay. If it's a little bit too much for you to close your eyes in this moment, then keep them open and focus on one spot out in front of you. Start to connect to your breath, just the natural rhythm of your inhale and your exhale through your nose. Allow yourself to transition from all the news and chatter of the external world to see what's going on in your internal world. Allow yourself to be in the space that you are in right now, leaving everything else behind. I know the mind may want to hold on to whatever else is happening in your life right now, and I get that completely. As best as you can, focus on your breath. Every inhale and every exhale. As you inhale, you breathe into the nose. Feel the breath go down the throat, into your chest, and into your belly. As you exhale, feel the breath come from the belly up through the chest, the back of the throat, and out through the nose. Again, as you inhale, you feel the breath enter the nostrils, down the throat, chest, and belly. As you exhale from the belly up through the chest, the throat, out through the nose, over the top of your lip. Keep going. We're going into our deeper breath now, into the belly. Exhale through the nose, draw your navel back towards your spine. Start to feel the temperature of the room you're in. Anytime you are in fear or anxiety, bring yourself to this moment, the present moment. So feel the temperature of the room. Feel the earth, the ground underneath you, fully supporting you right now and always. Feel your eyelids touching. Your eyebrow center softening. Allow your jaw to relax. Observe any sounds that you hear around you, whether they are coming from the video or the space you're in. Back to the breath, deep breaths into the belly. And we're going to start a three-part breath, so follow closely as you inhale, breathe into the belly first, breathe into the chest, breathe into your shoulders, and hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale from the shoulders, exhale from the chest, exhale from the belly. Hold out, 2, 3, 4. Inhale to the belly. Inhale to the chest. Inhale to your shoulders. And hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale from your shoulders. Exhale from your chest. Exhale from your belly. Hold out, 2, 3, 4. Inhale belly, inhale chest, inhale shoulders, and hold. Exhale shoulders, exhale chest, exhale belly, hold out. Keep going on your own, best as you can. Don't worry if it's not exact. Once you're finished, come back to the deep breath solely into the belly, in and out through your nose. Now I invite you to set an intention for your practice tonight. What is it that you need on your mat right now? What is it that's calling to you? Maybe it's more freedom, release of whatever thoughts are going on in the mind, maybe release of the anxiety, allowing it to process. Maybe it's simply to move. Whatever it is you are needing, start to repeat it to yourself internally as if it's already happening for you in this moment. Now bring your hands to your heart center in prayer posture and bow your head down to lock the intention in. Keep the hands together as you inhale, bring your head back up to neutral, reach your arms up towards the sky, palms still touching. Exhale, open the hands, release your intention out to whatever you go to, whether it's God, nature, love, totality, hands onto your knees, stay with that deep breath. And we'll start our gentle warm up. As you inhale, start to circle your nose up towards the sky. As you exhale, circle your nose down towards the earth. Again, inhale, you circle up. And exhale, circle down. One more this direction. On your next inhale, circle the opposite way. Stay with the breath, stay in the body as you are moving. As you inhale, bring your head back up to neutral. Drop your right ear towards your right shoulder. Option to take your right hand, place it on the left side of your head, putting gentle pressure. And then maybe even take that left arm, wrap it around your back, reaching towards the right hip. Keep sitting up nice and tall. Breathe into the belly. Two more big breaths here. As you inhale, release, bring your head back up to neutral. Other side, exhale, left ear towards your left shoulder. Option to take your left hand, place it on the right side of your head, putting gentle pressure. Maybe even take that right arm, reach it around back towards the left hip. Again, stay with every inhale and every exhale. Really observe the subtleties of the breath, how it feels against the nostrils, the back of your throat. It feels a little cooler or warmer. One more breath here. As you inhale, release, bring your head back up to neutral. Bring your hands onto your knees, palms to face down. We're going to take a cat-cow while we are here. As you inhale, jut the ribs out in front of you. Open the heart forward. As you exhale, round your spine. Gently tuck the chin towards the chest and round. Inhale, cow. Bring the heart forward. Gaze up to the ceiling. Exhale, cat. Round the spine. Tuck the chin in. Again, inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Keep going with your breath pace. And keep in mind, if your breath is a little longer or a little shorter than ours, that is perfectly fine. You go at your pace, whatever you need tonight. On All right, let's start to pick up the pace now, everyone, intentionally. So as you inhale, come forward, exhale back, inhale forward, exhale back, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, keep going. Really let the back of your heart open, let the front of your heart open, keep going. Pick up the pace a little more now. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, front, back, front, back, keep it going. We have 20, 19, 18, 17, a little faster, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, slow it down, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back to a neutral spine, fingertips to the ground on either side of your body, right hand stays down, inhale, left arm up, reach it towards the ceiling. Exhale, reach the left arm towards the right, bend the right elbow, go as low as you can here. Inhale, back to center, we switch, left hand grounds down, right arm comes up. Exhale, reach towards the left. Again, inhale, up. Exhale, reach towards the right. Keep going just like this on your own pace. And again, stay in the body as you're moving. Feel the movement in the moment that it's happening right now. Inhale, center. Exhale, right hand down, lift the left arm up. This time I want you to fold forward. You're gonna reach the left hand in the diagonal that the right knee is going in. Breathe into your hips and your lower back here. One more big breath. As you inhale, come back up through center. Plant the left hand down, right arm up. Exhale, right hand reaches in the diagonal that the left knee is shooting out. Fold over here. You have one more big breath. Breathe into the back channel of your body. Inhale, you come back up through center. Exhale, place your hands on your knees one more time. We have one more movement as we are seated here. We're going to start to make circles with the rib cage, and you're going to go counterclockwise. What this does is it helps the energy to rise up in your body, up from the tailbone, the base of your spine, all the way up, out through the crown of your head. So as you inhale, I want you to shoot the ribs out forward. Again, you're making a circle. As you exhale, you shoot the ribs back, leading from the rib cage. Inhale forward, exhale back. Keep going just like this. And again, you can close your eyes here to really stay inward in this moment. Inhale forward, exhale back. We go a little faster. Inhale forward, exhale back. Inhale forward, exhale back. Forward and back. Keep it going. And tap into the energy in your body right now. See how it's feeling. See if you can feel, and maybe you can't, and that's perfectly fine, but feel any of those emotions that have been stuck inside of you. See if you can feel them starting to move a little bit more. Pick up the pace. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Keep it going. We have 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, a little faster, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, start to slow it down, 3, 2, 1, keep the eyes closed now, and you're gonna still be spinning slightly here, but no effort in the spinning. Let it come back to neutral, nice and easy when the energy is ready. Start to blink the eyes open now if they were closed, and everyone transitions to 4 points. Tabletop, hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Extend your right leg back, lift it up into the air. So right leg is up, left arm reaches forward. We're gonna stay here for some balancing. While you're here, hug the ribs in towards one another. Draw your navel up towards your spine, and your right hip is facing down towards the earth. Now you have the option to stay here. If you wanna take it a little further though, bring your left hand to the back of your head. On your exhale, bring your knee and elbow to touch underneath you. Inhale, you lengthen. Exhale, we touch. Inhale, lengthen. Give me two more just like this. As you exhale, bring your hand and your knee back down onto the earth. We have the other side. Left leg extends back, lifts up into the air. Right arm reaches forward. And again, this is your practice. So if this is what you need tonight and you don't want to take it further, then don't. That's perfectly fine. Right hand to the back of your head. If you like, as you exhale, bring your knee and elbow to touch. Inhale, we lengthen. Exhale, touch. Inhale, lengthen. Give me two more. As you exhale, drop your hand and your knee back down onto the earth. Everyone, tuck your toes under. Lift your knees 2 inches off the earth. Floating tabletop while we're here, activating the core a little bit more and the arms as well. Triceps are wrapping back. Lift your knees another 2 inches. Now lift your hips up, downward facing dog. Pedal your feet out while you're here, bending one knee and then the other. Maybe shake your head yes and shake your head no. Inhale your right leg up, bend your knee and stack your hip. Gaze goes underneath your right underarm. If this is a little too much for you, come down onto the left knee and the left forearm on the earth. Start to circle that right knee, getting into your right hip flexor. Circle the opposite direction. Inhale, right leg straight up. Exhale, right foot to the outside of your right hand. Drop your left knee down onto the earth. Walk your hands forward as far as the body will allow. You're here. If you do want to take it a little further here, you can always tuck the back toes, lift your back knee up, and floss your hips, rocking front to back. I'll let Miguel do that version. 2 more breaths here. Breathing into your hips. Now Now, if you're flossing the hips, go ahead and drop the back knee down onto the mat. Everyone walk your hands out past the edges of your mat. We're going into 3 push-ups while we're here, just as deep as your body will allow. So as you exhale, bend the elbows, lower your torso down towards the mat. As you inhale, you lengthen the arms back out. Exhale, you bend. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bend. And inhale, lengthen. Walk your hands back to be underneath your shoulders. Left hand stays down, right arm reaches up. We twist. We're gonna start to make circles with that right arm. So as you exhale, start to circle it back. And as you inhale, start to circle it out in front of you, opening through that right shoulder. Exhale, circle back. Inhale, forward. Give me 2 more, just like this. Last one, inhale, forward. This time, everyone, exhale, reach it back. Keep reaching back. Maybe this is enough for you right now, or if you'd like, you can bend the left knee, reach back with your right hand, and see if you can grab your foot. If you can't grab the foot, that's perfectly fine. Keep reaching towards it, or maybe utilize a strap or a belt to wrap around the foot and hold on to the strap. Keep opening your heart forward. Press that left hip flexor forward a little more, getting deeper into the flexor and into the quad. And slowly release, bringing your right hand back down onto the mat. Everyone take it back into a downward facing dog. We're gonna stay with the right leg, so same side. Inhale your right leg straight up into the air, point through your toes. Your right hip is facing down. We're gonna start to circle that right leg, start to make circles. Again, getting into the hip sockets. Keep reaching through the toes, circle the opposite direction. Inhale, right leg straight up. Exhale, right foot to the outside of your right hand. Again, drop the back knee down, walk your hands as far forward as your body will allow. Maybe you even drop the forearms to the earth. We stay here for some breaths. One more big breath here. Start to walk your hands back underneath the shoulders. We're going to skip the push-ups for this round. Bring that right arm back up into the air. We're going to skip the circles again and go straight into bending that left knee. Grab onto your left foot if you can with the right hand, but this time we're switching it up by pushing the left foot into your right hand. So you're pushing it away from that left glute. Gives it a little bit more of a different sensation, a little more engagement. Keep breathing into the belly. 2 more, keep opening your heart up. Don't sink down into that left shoulder. Keep lengthening the left ear away from the shoulder. And release, right hand to the earth. Make your way back downward, facing dog. Take a moment here to cuddle the feet. Have the other side. Inhale your left leg up, bend your knee and stack your hip. And again, option to drop the right knee down, maybe even the right forearm. Start to circle that left knee. Keep your core active, drawing the navel back. Circle in the opposite direction. Inhale, left leg straight up. Exhale, left foot to the outside of your left hand. Again, option to drop the back knee or keep it lifted in the air. Walk your hands out in front of you as far as your body will allow. Now, if you want to take it a little further, you can be like Miguel and start to floss the hips, rocking front to back. One more big breath here. If you're flossing your hips, go ahead and drop the right knee back down. Separate your hands past the edges of your mat. We have 3 push-ups while we're here. As you exhale, bend the elbows, sink the heart down as much as you can. Inhale, you lengthen the arms back out. Exhale, you sink. Inhale, lengthen. Last one, sink. And lengthen. Walk your hands back underneath your shoulders. Right hand stays down, left arm reaches up. Inhale. Exhale, start to circle that left arm back behind you. Inhale, circle it forward. Exhale, back. Inhale, forward. It doesn't matter, you can go that way. Keep going just like that. Follow your breath. We have two more rounds. As you exhale, bring that left hand back, bend the right knee, see if you can grab onto your foot. Again, if you can't, that is not a problem. Keep reaching for the foot, though. Your right heel is being drawn in towards your right glute. Keep opening your heart up, no sinking down onto that left or to the right shoulder. An option while you're here to also drop that right forearm down to go even deeper into it if you'd like. One more big breath. And release. Left hand down onto the earth and step it back. Downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Everyone, inhale that left leg straight up. Point through the toes. Reach them back behind you. Start to circle that left leg. As best as you can, left hip is facing down, not opening up. Circle the opposite direction. Now inhale, lift it straight up. Exhale, step the left foot to the outside of your left hand, drop the back knee down, and walk your hands out in front of you as far as your body will allow. We'll stay here for some breaths. And if you'd like, you can floss the hips again, that's not a problem. You do what you need tonight. You do you, boo. One more big breath. Now everyone, drop the back knee down. If it's up in the air, walk your hands underneath the shoulders. We're reaching that left arm up, going into our twist, and bending into that right knee straight away, reaching the left arm back. Press your right foot into your left hand, so you're pushing it away from your glute. Press the right hip flexor forward. Breathe into whatever tension you may be feeling here. And release. Left hand back down onto the earth. Take it back. Downward facing dog. Nice and easy. Start to walk your feet forward to meet your hands. One step at a time. We're not rushing. Once you're at the top of your mat, stay folded over for your ragdoll. Let yourself hang heavy, whatever that looks like for you tonight. So maybe you grab opposite elbows and find a sway. Maybe you interlace your fingers on the back of your head. Or maybe you bring your hands to your sacrum, interlace the fingers and reach the arms up. Whatever you prefer here. Most important though, keep the head hanging heavy. There's nothing to watch on the screen right now. One more big breath here. Go ahead and release your arms back down onto the earth. Bring a small bend into your knees. Keep your chin tucked in towards the chest the entire time. And I want you to slowly, I mean slowly, start to roll up, stacking your bones one on top of the other. Stay with your breath. Don't worry if you're going too slow or too fast. There's no doing yoga wrong because you are the yoga. Without you, it wouldn't exist. So let any idea of that go. Bring your head all the way up. We're in a standing position, or maybe you're not, and that's perfectly fine. Now I want us to head back down. I want you to start by tucking your chin in first towards the chest, start to roll down, but this time, as you're rolling down, if there's any moment where you feel extra tension in your back, I want you to pause in that moment. Breathe into the tension, give it some love, and then start to slowly keep rolling all the way down until you're folded over. Breathe into the back body, into your spine. Small bend in the knees. Once you're all the way folded over, same thing last time. Start to roll up nice and slow, taking your time and pausing when you need to, whenever you feel that extra tension or something arise for you in your body, pause there, breathe into it. Keep the chin tucked into the chest. Into your mountain pose, all the way up, stacking your head on top of your shoulders, hands come to your heart center, eyes are closed. We're taking three clearing breaths, hands in prayer posture, inhale, fill the belly up, open your mouth, exhale it out, again, inhale, fill up, open the mouth, sigh it out. Last one. Inhale, fill up. Open the mouth, stick the tongue out. Exhale. Come back to breathing in and out through your nose. And we take a gentle sun A. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, right leg steps back, only come into a runner's lunge. We're gonna bounce the hips here now for 10, 9, 8, they're easy, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, step the left leg back, high plank, down to low plank, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, down dog, hips in to the air. Stay here, marinate in your down dog for some breaths. Slightly bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, feet to your hands. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, hands to your heart center, going again. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, left leg steps back, runner's lunge. We bounce the hips now for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it back into a high plank, chaturanga down. Into low plank. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Now I am. Exhale, down dog, hips up. Into the air. Stay here for some breaths.
how you suffered for your sanity. I tried to set them free. They were not listening, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now.
Inhale, slightly bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, feet to your hands. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise all the way up. Lengthen the ribcage away from the pelvis. Exhale, hands to your heart. We have one more round. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Uttanasana. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, chaturanga. Step both feet back. High to low plank. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, down dog, hips into the air. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, step the right foot forward. Drop the back knee down onto the earth. Inhale, arms rise. Give me a small back bend. Exhale, half split. Straighten that front leg. Flex your right foot. Again, inhale, come forward. Maybe your hands stay down, or maybe they rise up, opening the heart. Exhale, half splits. Keep going. Three more, just like this, whatever variation you want. And maybe you use a blanket, or maybe you use a block to keep the ground closer to you. Whatever you need. Stay in the body as you're moving here. We have one more round. We meet in our half split now. We'll stay here. Take your left arm across the right leg. Walk your hands towards the right side. Keep that right pinky toe reaching back towards the right hip. We're tapping more into the IT band now.
How you suffered for your sanity.
Two more breaths here.
To set them free. They will not listen, they're not listening still.
Walk your hands back. Come forward into your low runner's lunge, bending into the right knee. Plant the hands, take it back. Downward facing dog. We have the other side. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, bring the foot through. Plant the right knee down onto the earth. Inhale, arms rise. Open up the heart. And exhale, straighten that left leg. Flex your left foot. Again, inhale, you come back forward. Maybe your hands stay down, or maybe they rise up like we go. And exhale, half splits. Three more rounds on your own. Keep reaching your heart forward, push it through the arms. One more round. Straighten that left leg out. Flex your left foot. Left pinky toes reaching back towards the left hip. Start to walk your hands over towards the left side. Getting into the IT band. Lengthen through your heart. Two more breaths. Start to walk your hands back forward, coming into your low runner's lunge. Plant the hands, step it back, downward facing dog. Inhale, slightly bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, step your way into a seated position on your mats. Straighten your legs out in front of you. Flex your feet so your toes are reaching back towards you. Inhale, arms rise. Exhale, fold forward. You can grab onto your shins, your ankles, your feet. If you have extra space in the backs of your legs, maybe you take a block, place it in front of your feet, and you're here. Now I want you to lengthen through the spine so you have as much of a flat back as possible. You're leading through your heart, always. Two more big breaths here.
When you're done, I'll make you do it all again. All again.
And slowly release, walking the hands back towards your thighs. Bring a small bend into your knees. Take your forearms, slide them underneath the legs. Let the weight of your legs drop down onto the arms, round your spine. While you're here, tuck your chin in towards your chest. Keep tucking the chin in, keep flexing your feet. We're opening the whole back channel of the body while we're here, so big breaths into the back, especially the lower back, and behind your heart, between the shoulder blades. Once you're all the way on the ground, hug your knees in to your chest. Start to rock from side to side, giving your spine some love. And circle your knees in one direction. And circle in the opposite. Back down onto the mat. Take your right leg, cross it over the left. Maybe you stay here, or maybe you double cross it, taking your right toes behind the left calf muscle. Bring your knees back up into the air, arms out into a T. Start to drop your knees over towards the left side. Right shoulder stays down as much as possible. Gaze is either up towards the ceiling or over your right shoulder. Big breaths into your hips, into your lower back. Let the breath start to lengthen a little bit more. One more here. As you inhale, come back to center. You can bring the feet back down to reset for the other side, so left leg crosses over, or you can do it in the air. Drop your knees over to the right. Left shoulder stays down. And you don't have to double cross it, just keep it like that. That's okay. Gaze stays up towards the ceiling or over the left shoulder. And please keep in mind, you do not need to double cross. One cross is perfect.
Big breath. Stay here. Unwind, stamp your feet on the ground, bring your feet to touch, knees out towards the edges of your mat, reclining butterfly pose. Let everything start to soften. The breath softens even more. Go ahead and let go of any control of your breathing. Let it come back into its natural rhythm. Soften the entire body. Let the head, the back of your head, get heavy onto your mats. Now you have the option to stay here for your shavasana and reclining butterfly, or you can straighten out the legs and take your traditional shavasana. It's up to you. Just as long as you get comfortable, you can flatten out or stay reclining in the butterfly. Start to let go of all effort. And like Miguel is doing, you can also take legs up a wall or legs up a sofa as well. Just as long as you're on the ground, comfortable. I'll be in a seated position, but you do not need to be. Let everything soften. I want you to envision and feel this wave of relaxation starting to radiate out from deep within you, from your bones, deep within your bones. This relaxation starts to radiate out into your muscles, wrapping your muscles in relaxation, letting them rest, going out into all your organs, letting all the organs soften into your joints, into your fascia, into your skin. This wave of relaxation keeps radiating all around you. You are in, it's inside of you and wrapped all around you, this relaxation. And for this moment, allow yourself to simply rest. to bring a deeper breath back into your body. Bring small movements into your fingers and into your toes. Gently rock your head from side to side. Inhale, take the head to one side. As you exhale, bring it closer towards the earth. Inhale, come back to the center. And exhale, switch. Give yourself a good morning stretch, reaching your arms up and over your head. And when you're ready, make your way onto your favorite side, into a fetal position on your mat. I want you to physically, give yourself a hug. Wrap your arms around yourself, give yourself a hug. Know that there is nothing off or wrong or out of place in this moment. Everything is exactly as it should be. Give yourself love. Say to yourself, I love you, whether internal or external. Know that this too shall pass. And thank yourself for showing up on your mat tonight. Whenever you're ready, start to slowly make your way up into a seated meditation pose. And we'll meet with our eyes closed and hands at heart center in prayer posture. We'll seal off tonight's practice with one clearing breath, followed by an Om. Everyone inhale deeply. Open the mouth, let it out. Inhale for Om. The gift of yoga tonight. From my heart to yours, with much love, namaste. Alrighty, y'all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We hope that you continue to join us. I hope this helped you all get a little bit more relaxation, a little bit more peace during this time. I know for me, myself, I'm feeling a lot of stuff rise up throughout the day, just emotions wanting to rise because there is so much change. Life isn't gonna be the same as we used to know it. So there is a grieving period that's happening right now. There's a mix of emotions coming up. You can feel, you can hear it in my throat. So I hope you continue to join us. Thank you so much. And also, in case you missed it, this Saturday morning, I'm going to be doing a Facebook Live. There is no event where we're going to be meeting at a location. This is all going to be through Facebook, but I'm going to be doing a class through the McAllen Sunset Live Concert Series. They asked me to host a yoga class for their Facebook page, so I will be doing that. It is a donation-based class. That one will be, it's not going to be on the Quiet Mind Yoga page. It'll be on the Sunset Live Concert Series page. Hopefully y'all join. And also, remember, share this with everyone and anyone that you would like. If you post photos or video, make sure to tag us. And thank you all so much. I love you very, very much. We'll see you later.
I
Bye, y'all.